foundation for everything the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency does to protect the nation's air, water, and land, and safeguard public health, is science. EPA scientists and engineers provide the scientific and technical solutions needed by states and communities to address real-world environmental problems. To meet that goal, EPA engages states, tribes, and local governments to ensure our efforts match the specific needs of communities across America. In California, EPA researchers worked with state environmental agencies to protect people from the effects of wildfires. We're partnering with Oklahoma to provide technical reviews of groundwater and surface water interactions for contaminated sites. And in Louisiana, we worked with the state to evaluate potential cancer risks to reduce emissions of chloroprene from a rubber factory. Wherever they're needed, scientists with EPA's Office of Research and Development, or ORD, are there. Like along the Merrimack River, a source of drinking water for New Hampshire residents. Local officials are concerned about elevated levels of perfluorinated compounds resulting from industrial activities that began in the 1970s and 80s.
Through some experience some of our people had with scientists at the Office of Research and Development, we understood that they had new and advanced capabilities to go out and look for the next generation of compounds that we really couldn't order tests from commercial labs for. A lot of the work was us explaining what we were seeing in the field and what we weren't able to see in the field, them helping us understand how we could take samples and get them to them, and then they did their advanced testing, which is the non-targeted methods that commercial labs don't have. There are things ORD can do because they're resourced at a national level that no state can realistically do. Without access to ORD's capabilities, I really don't know that we would have the same kind of picture that we have today.
In the Midwest, EPA researchers work with the state of Ohio to better understand how environmental conditions, including excess nutrients, were potentially sparking harmful algal blooms, also called HABs, that threaten drinking water supplies and shut down beaches, lakes, and swimming holes.
One of the challenges with emerging contaminants, including HABs and cyanotoxins, is as a state, we don't have the technology or the methodology developed yet. And that is one of the benefits of working with US EPA Office of Research and Development. Ohio EPA and the Division of Drinking Groundwater worked hand in hand with US EPA's Office of Research and Development, not only in the response to the City of Toledo harmful algal bloom incident, but in all the work afterwards where we developed rules and regulations for cyanotoxins at public water systems. This is cutting edge science and new methodologies that we don't have time or access to as a regulatory agency. And I think going forward with the issues of emerging contaminants, the value of this partnership and materials and technology and just expertise that they bring is the states are going to need it more than ever going forward.
When it comes to meeting environmental and related public health challenges, there is no one-size-fits-all solution. Conducted in partnership with states and local communities, EPA Research delivers the scientific and technical solutions we need to protect human health and the environment.